Come in. Come right here. Let's talk about something really quick. So, as you can tell by the title, this is literally for individuals like myself who are free thinkers and who don't, I'm not going to say who don't believe in rules and regulations, but this is for people who more so see outside of the veil. And when I say that, it's like you don't just take things as you're told. You do research, you look into things, you study things, and you know, you kind of, not kind of, but more than anything, you use your intuition to follow your gut feelings. I promise I'm gonna make this video short because it's a very simple video, right? So for a lot of individuals, and I've been doing this for a long time, right? Because I'm a very spiritual person. Clearly I have a YouTube channel that's geared towards tarot, spirituality, right? This is just something that I know I need to put out because I feel like a lot of people are in a frenzy and they're panicked. And I feel like a lot of people don't have the adequate information. And this is going to be so super simple, so super simple. And just starting off, I want you guys to question or ask yourself, if you are questioning doing this, what I'm about to talk to you guys about, why? And you have the right to do what you want to do, but it's like, it's not going to hurt you at all, right? So what I'm going to talk about is there's a lot of talks about 5G radiation exposure. I know for a fact this is a real thing. This is definitely a real thing. But even if you don't believe in the 5G radiation exposure theory, conspiracy theories, this is also what I'm about to talk about right now. This also reflects on spiritual health. Okay, so even if you don't care anything about, you know, conspiracy theories, I'm not a conspiracy theorist. I tune into what it is that I know is real, right? I've always done this, and this is going to be very quick and very simple, so let's get straight to the point. This is about, like, a detox bath, detox slash spiritual bath, right? Very simple. You don't have to go buy hundreds of dollars of herbs, hundreds of dollars of crystals and things like that. This is, you're literally going to use two ingredients. Two. Now, when I say that, it doesn't have to be this specific brand of salt, but I'm going to tell you to do this, to take a detox bath for this specific thing, baking soda, sea salt, not iodine table salt, sea salt, pink Himalayan sea salt, or like I have this, I typically always use pink Himalayan sea salt because that's, you know, that's one of my favorite things, but I was drawn to this, and so I took it. Either way it goes, it's not iodine salt. So let's go back for a second. Radiation, 5G is radiation exposure that will make you sick. It breaks down your cells. It will make you literally have flu-like symptoms. It causes cancer. It causes blood diseases, things like that. It will make you sick, very sick. And you need to be mindful about that. There are ways, because if you live in an area especially, and you need to research that, like where the cellular towers are around, how close they are to your home and your place of employment. Because keep in mind, most of us work full-time full-time hours. So you're at a workplace for 40 hours a week. Pay attention to, and it's public record, right? So you can Google and ask, where are cellular towers in my area? And it will give you a whole map popping up and showing where cellular towers are in your area. And you are being exposed to massive amounts of radiation every single day. I don't care if you're one of those type of people who don't keep your phone on you, you're rarely on your phone, it doesn't matter. Most people, it's rare that you will find a person who is not, who doesn't have a cell phone. It's rare. I don't care if you're not on it physically, texting on it, doesn't matter. At the end of the day, most people have a phone clip in their purse, in their pocket. You are still exposing your body to radiation every single day. I don't care who you are. Your TV, even certain brands of light bulbs, radiation. Your laptops, radiation. You are exposing your body and your whole genetic makeup to radiation. Everybody, every single day. Like I said, if you are one of those people, you know, like the baby boomers who don't really care for cell phones and things like that, it doesn't matter. You have a TV, radiation. Okay, you are at, if you're working, radiation. Every single day you are exposed to those vibrations, those energies. No one is immune to it. Okay, nobody here on earth. So if you don't care about the 5G conspiracy theories and things like that, doesn't matter, you're still being exposed every single day to radiation. So here's a simple thing that I want you guys to do so that you can detox your body from it and lessen the effects on how it affects your body, because it breaks down your cellular DNA. It, and if you're predisposed, especially if you have a family history of cancer, this will trigger that and speed it up, and you will be more susceptible to those symptoms and for, you know, your cellular breakdown that will cause you to, you know, cancer to formulate in your body. So this is very simple. You, like I said, two things. This is so simple. You're gonna do one cup, like a measuring cup, not a full damn cup like when you drink your glass of water. One measuring cup. You can get a glass beaker, whatever. One cup. You're gonna fill it with baking soda. One cup. That's it. One cup. Sea salt. You're gonna take both of these cups, dump it in your bath water. That's all you're doing. I told y'all this is gonna be like super easy. Very easy. Now, when you ask what does that do, it literally detoxes impurities out of your body, completely detoxes impurities out of your body. Now, for people who follow me and you know, you're subscribed to my channel, you know I always leave links in the description box below. So for those skeptics and people who don't believe in, you know, spirituality and things like that, I know there's a lot of people who are analytical. My rising sign is Virgo, so I could be analytical, and that's why I know that there's people out there like me who wants statistics and facts. There's a study, a literal study, right, from patients, cancer patients who take radiation therapy, chemotherapy, and this is documented about how literally just using these two things helps reduce the radiation in their bodies, helps reduce the toxins from radiation in your body. And I'm going to leave that in the link in the description box below, because like I said, a lot of people like to see statistics, right? Also, if you're more spiritually inclined like myself, I've been doing this for years. I'm 35 years old right now. I've been doing this since I was 29, right? When you mix these two items together on a spiritual level, you dump it in your tub the same way. And I didn't say this before, but let me say it before I get into this dialogue. You're going to sprinkle it from the front to the back of the tub so that it's on both ends. It doesn't matter. You don't have to mix it together. You don't have to put it in a bowl and mix it together. If you do, that's fine, because think about it. Once it gets in the water, it's going to do what it needs to do anyway. You're literally going to do one cup of both. And I have to reiterate, do not do this more than once a week. You want to do this one time every single week, because baking soda is very detoxing and it's very drying. So it will dry your skin out, right? It will dry your skin out. And sea salt, especially, and be mindful, health purposes, right? If you are someone who deals with high blood pressure and things of that nature, use discretion. I'm a medical profession, right? But I'm not a doctor. I can't tell you what your specific case is. But so be mindful when you do stuff like that, because I've never had issues. I do this with my children. Me and my children, I put their butts in this bath, because, you know, I have a 10-year-old and a 12-year-old. They're always on their cell phones. I literally give them breaks 2 hours at a time, and then 2-4 hours off. Go play, go do some stuff like I did when I was your age. You know, you're not just gonna sit on a tablet or a phone all day sucking up all that energy, right? You literally just once a week. You don't need more than that. You don't. And I know this, I just want to give someone a sense of peace and calm, because I know if you're frantic and you're kind of worked up, the first thing you want to do is, I'm gonna double up on it. No, don't do that. I said, come here, don't do that. Don't double up on it. Did you hear me? Don't double up on it. Do it once a week. Because think about it, in a work week or, you know, whatever it is you're doing in everyday life, you're literally exposed to it every single day. But this is so powerful. I wouldn't tell you something that I don't do personally. I did it last night. And usually, you want to put the water as hot as your body can tolerate. Don't give yourself no third-degree burns. Don't go out there and just like make it so hot that you literally can't even sit in the water and you burn yourself. I'm not telling you that. As hot as your body can tolerate. Once you step your foot in that water and you feel like, oh, this is too hot, add some cooler water to it. But you want it to be warm enough, to hot enough for you to sweat, because you're sweating out impurities. Everybody knows once you sweat, you're sweating out impurities in your body. It's going to make you sweat. And it's supposed to. You're sweating out impurities. So you want to make the water as warm as your body can tolerate. And you want to, the goal is to sit in there for 30 minutes, period. For me last night, I'm going to tell you, I made it so hot and it was potent that I literally could only sit there for like 16 minutes because I felt a little lightheaded and dizzy. And I'm going to tell you guys, that's common. You're going to feel a little lightheaded and dizzy because you're literally going to feel your energy lifting. Like, you're going to feel your energy lifting. I slept like a baby. I'm an insomniac. I've been like that since I was a child. All my life I've been an insomniac. I've always been like that. I slept like a baby. I think I did it at like 11 o'clock last night. I literally didn't wake up until 11 o'clock this morning, literally. So I slept that whole period of time because it regenerated me. You know, it kind of lifted my energy. Not kind of, it literally lifted my energy. When I woke up, it felt like a weight was off of my body. You're going to feel that. But initially, because first of all, you're sweating, and then there's the steam from the hot water, and then these two things mixed together, it can make you feel a little lightheaded. Don't try to force yourself to sit in there for the full 30 minutes. If you feel lightheaded or dizzy, get out. Because it's doing what it needs to do. Okay, again, I'm going to leave a link in the description box below so you can look at it. I'm going to leave the link for the medical proof that it's very helpful with radiation. And then I'm going to leave the spiritual link. You know, like I said, I'm supporting both sides. People who are more analytical and people who are more spiritually grown. Either way it goes, it's going to tie in for both of you guys. This is a powerful thing, and it's so simple. You know, don't spend your money on all these herbs and crazy things. Not to say that it's not helpful. This is by far the cheapest thing you can do. I think for this salt, I paid probably like $4, $4 or $5. And then this, you can get this at a Dollar Tree for a dollar. You ain't got a dollar? I'll send you a dollar. Okay? It's a dollar. And that's some of the cheapest things you can do once a week. Okay? So, what was I looking at my notes? Okay, so for the spiritual sense, your aura. Literally, this does the same thing. You're clearing your aura, right? And when I say you're clearing your aura, every day when we go out and we connect with other people and things like that, we connect with people and their energy. And if you know about auras, your body has like a shield, like a glowing shield around it, right? Like a little force field, like a bubble. And every time you meet people, good or bad, whatever their energy is, you connect with them and their energy connects to you. It sticks to your aura, especially people, if you're intimate with these people, if they're people that you see every day, like your coworkers, like if your coworker comes in a bad mood, that energy attaches to you and it just sticks to your aura. You need to clean your aura every single day. You need to do that. So when you do this on a more spiritual level, right, you want to see like a gold bubble around your body, around your whole body. And while you're sitting in the bathtub, you literally want to see it glowing brighter and brighter and brighter, and just see like little spots in your mind. See little spots on your aura, and as you take the water, you just kind of flush it all over you. See it being washed off of your body, washed off of your aura, and going into the water. That's a spiritual thing, and it really does work. Like I said, I'm telling you, I guarantee you, once you do this, you're gonna feel so much lighter. So much lighter. Since this pandemic thing has gone on or started, I've had headaches every single day. First of all, I'm an empath. So I pick up everybody's frenzy and their, you know, all of the calamity, I pick it up. And I feel everything on a deeper level, almost like it's my own energy. I'm an empath to the 10th power. And I'm also a life path number 11, so I'm very psychically inclined, intuitive. I pick up everybody's energy. And you know, since that started, I've had headaches every single day. But I also knew that I was being exposed to massive amounts of radiation because one of my main businesses is online. So I'm always on my phone, my laptop, things like that. So I'm cutting back my usage of things that are electronical, but also I need to know and I have to perform tasks that allows me to detox my body. This is by far the simplest thing that you can do. And it's very cheap. And it's very affordable. Like I said, one cup sea salt, one cup baking soda. That's it. You literally take the cups, dump it in your water from, like, you know, sprinkle it from the head to the toe of your bathtub. Sprinkle sea salt, sprinkle the baking soda. That's it. Sit in the bathtub. It's recommended for 30 minutes. If you can't do 30 minutes, if you feel dizzy or lightheaded, that means it's kicked that stuff out of your system and it's done its job. If you feel dizzy or lightheaded, don't force yourself to stay in that bathtub. Get up, get out, and go lay down. Because I can tell you, you're going to feel so light. It literally feels like you're floating. And if you're one of those type of panicky people, you might be a little scared, like, oh shit, you know, what's going on? Don't panic. You're fine, right? It's just detoxing your body, you know, and that's going to happen. And it's also, I'm going to tell you also just some tips. Don't panic about it. It will make you urinate a lot, and you may have, you shouldn't have liquidy bowel movements. You shouldn't. That's a completely different thing. But your stool will be more regular. You know what I mean? Because that's how toxins leave our body, is through our waste. Urine and stool, it leaves your body. That's the number one sign that is really working for you, is when you're urinating more and, you know, you're releasing through waste, the stool. That's a positive thing. And again, like I said, you shouldn't be having like runny loose stools, because if that's the case, then that's something else that's going on. But technically, you know, this isn't one of those things where you need to be concerned about, you know, unless you're allergic to baking soda or sea salt. But again, you would know how that applies to your own personal situation, right? So be mindful about the things that you do, any and everything in your life. Be mindful about the things that you do and the things that you include into your health and your body regimens, because right now we're dealing with spiritual health. And when I say free thinkers, that's why this is titled the way that it is, because a lot of people will look at this and they'll say like, 5G, you people are conspiracy theorists and you're just being ridiculous. There's so much information on the web, and most people don't look, because fear-based thoughts, people don't want to see the truth because it's scary. When you realize that everything isn't what you always thought it was, that's scary for a lot of people. I have friends that I've known for years who literally tell me like, I don't want to hear this, I don't want to know. You don't want to know. You just want to keep living your life and not being aware of what's going on. I respect it. But for the people like you and I, because if you're watching this video, you're in tune with what I'm talking about, right? For people like you and I who realize that there's more than meets the eye and there's more than what they're exposing and what they're telling us, you need to know how to protect yourself and your family. Because your health, if you, I don't care how wealthy you are financially, if you don't have your wealth, your financial wealth, I mean your physical health and wealth, none of that matters. You can be a billionaire, and if your health declines, you will literally be in a negative, right? You have to protect yourself, you have to protect your health, you have to just balance your energy. I don't tell people what to do. I don't like people preaching to me. I don't like it. I just like to give facts, right? And the fact is, I've done this, like I said, since I was 29 years old. I'm 35 right now. I've never been sick from it. If anything, it has literally lifted and uplifted my energy. Literally. You know, even if I'm having a really bad day and I have a really nasty attitude, like I've just been going through so much, I will force myself to take a sea salt and baking soda bath. And I literally, my energy is completely different. It really is. Because it just changes your whole vibe. It's like it lifts your energy. It detoxes anything that is stagnant and heavy and toxic. And you have to be mindful about that, because right now what's going on, especially if you're an empath, also on a more spiritual note, if you're an empath, you definitely want to do this once a week, because you're absorbing every single person's emotions, feelings, because you're like a sponge right now. And you have to be mindful about that, because energy is everywhere. I don't care if you go to the great mountains of ukulele lake or wherever you go, it's energy. It may be different than the energy in the city, because the energy in the city is busy and moving and it's so much hustle and bustle. Even if you go to the mountains, there's energy there. It may be a more zen and more peaceful energy, but energy never dies. Energy is ever living, forever. It never goes away, right? Energy is everything. Energy is all. So be mindful about your energy, okay? Again, 30 minutes, if you can tolerate it, in the hottest water that your body can tolerate. Don't burn yourself, because I didn't tell y'all to do that. Don't do that. Don't do it. Okay, 30 minutes in water as hot as you can tolerate. 1 cup sea salt, 1 cup baking soda. Don't say nothing about, I'm not telling you to add anything else, no herbs, no spices, no essential oils. No, just these two things. That's it. They're going to do their work together. Okay, once a week. And that's it, and that's all. And I wish everybody extreme health, positive, extreme, excellent health. now and moving forward and forever. Okay? So until next time, thank you for joining me today. Bye.